Desert Orchid looks as though he's tiring in the ground. Yahoo, who loves the mud, is full of running at the second last. Yahoo jumps from Desert Orchid, but Desert Orchid is running. He's trying to come again towards the near side. It's Yahoo on the far side, Desert Orchid towards the near side. Desert Orchid's accelerating as they come to the last. Yahoo on the far side, Desert Orchid on the near side. It's Desert Orchid on the near side, Yahoo on the far side. Desert Orchid drifting over towards the strong side. He's beginning to get up. Desert Orchid is beginning to get up as they race towards the line. There's a tremendous cheer from the crowd.
Desert Orchid had already captured the heart of the nation before his historic Cheltenham Gold Cup victory, but we all knew that for him to take his rightful place at the head of racing's Hall of Fame, he would have to win the blue ribbon of the turf. He may have had to go through hell to do it, but he certainly ended up in heaven. First 1982-83 season failed to show even a glimmer of the greatness to come. Desert Orchid managed to pick up just £350 in prize money for finishing second in an uncompetitive Sandown novice hurdle. It was in his second season that Desert Orchid's talent, though, really began to expose itself. His first victory was in an Ascot novice hurdle, where he poleaxed the opposition with a powerful front-running display that was to become his trademark. His first taste of defeat that season came when upped in distance, and that prompted trainer David Ellsworth to drop Desi back to 2 miles, and I could only sit and watch on, I haven't a light, as Desert Orchid steadily drew away from me.
two out this, and Desert Orchid over in the lead from, in second place, Calamont. Desert Orchid still some 8 to 10 to 12 lengths clear from Calamont in second, then Deep in Dead third, followed by I Haven't a Light 4, Derby Dilly 5. The leader comes down to the final flight, jumps it well, and Triumph here in store for Richard Lindley on Desert Orchid, who looked around to see the chasing group headed by Calamont a long way in arrears, and he comes up towards the nine on this favourite who's made all the running here at Kempton, and coming up towards the line, Desert Orchid's going to win it easily. Desert Orchid is the winner.
That scintillating victory encouraged Connections to take on the highly regarded Dodgy Future in Sandown's Tolworth Hurdle. But Dodgy Future was to run a dismal race, and I had the unenviable task of trying to turn around the form book on I Haven't a Light.
Trip is 2 miles, 8 flights of hurdles to jump, and the front running Desert Orchid is the leader. From Horn of Plenty in second place, then comes I Haven't a Light. In fact, I Haven't a Light second. Horn of Plenty is third. Then Dodgy Future and Harbour Master and Kilby Cavalier. Comes the second, and Desert Orchid in the lead. From I Haven't a Light in second place, and John Frankham on I Haven't a Light, certainly keeping closer tabs on Desert Orchid than he did last time up at Kempton. Desert Orchid leading from I Haven't a Light in second place. A colour change to those of you looking in colour now. Blue with a yellow diamond and a white cap. Very similar colours to Horn of Plenty, who is in the dark blue with a white cap, back in third place. But Desert Orchid now beginning to stretch and go clear of I Haven't a Light, then Horn of Plenty and Dodgy Future, the four-year-old on the outside of Horn of Plenty, then Harbour Master, Kilby Cavalier, the back marker at this stage as they begin to swing right-handed. And here Colin Brown gathering impetus on Desert Orchid, going 8 lengths clear of I Haven't a Light in second. Just 2 more flights of hurdles to jump, and Desert Orchid is in a long, long lead over I Haven't a Light in second place. Dodgy Future, the Triumph Hurdle antipose favourite, back in third place. And again, I Haven't a Light gets another reminder, but he's just beginning to close. They've got 2.5 furlongs to go. Desert Orchid in the lead from I Haven't a Light. Desert Orchid the leader, 2 out this, coming down to it. Desert Orchid in the lead from I Haven't a Light, coming down to the 2 out. Desert Orchid leads from I Haven't a Light in second place, and these were a long way clear of Kilby Cavalier, who stays on into third. Dodgy Future is back in fourth, then Harbour Master and Horn of Plenty. They've got one more flight of hurdles to jump. Desert Orchid in the lead, jumps it boldly and well. I Haven't a Light is in second place. They've still got a furlong to race, don't forget. And Desert Orchid is tiring, definitely tiring, but he's in a lead of some 6 lengths. That's being reduced to 5 though, as they race up the line. Desert Orchid from I Haven't a Light coming up towards the line. Desert Orchid from I Haven't a Light. Desert Orchid's going to hold on, ridden out to the line. He's got there. Desert Orchid is the winner. I Haven't a Light is second.
Desi then strolled to victory in Ascot's Datchet Hurdle and Wincanton's Pattern Hurdle before being thrown in at the deep end in the champion.
Racing down to the next flight, the fourth of the 8 flights in the champion hurdle, and the grey Desert Orchid with the advantage over the favourite Dawn Run now as they come to the fourth. Desert Orchid from Dawn Run. Then for auction, Buckhouse Sulabula on the outside. Fine Sun finding this gallop too much at the moment and somewhere behind the remainder as they race towards the next flight. The fifth, Dawn Run on the inside of Desert Orchid. Then closely grouped in behind are Sulabula for auction and Buckhouse, and then Seamer and Cutter Dash and Very Promising and Amora. Then Fred Kateri and Robin Wonder as they race towards the top of the hill now. 3 left to jump. In the champion hurdle, Dawn Run, the mare, on the inside of Desert Orchid. As they begin the run downhill, Sulabula right with them towards the outside. Buckhouse also right with them. For auctions, lost a little bit of ground. Coming down towards the next flight now, the third from home, Dawn Run on the inside with Buckhouse on the outside. Dawn Run from Buckhouse there, then comes Desert Orchid. Racing towards the second last flight now in the champion hurdle, and it's the mare Dawn Run being pressed by Buckhouse all the time on the far side. Dawn Run on the near side, Buckhouse on the far side, Seamer is in third place. Then comes Very Promising, racing round the home turn now, and it's John Joe O'Neill on Dawn Run from Buckhouse and Seamer as they race towards the final flight. It's Dawn Run in the lead from Seema and Buckhouse. Seema producing a great challenge towards the near side, but Dawn Run with the advantage. Dawn Run lands in the lead over the last from Seema, who's now gone a close second. And then very promising, finishing fast, and Seema on the near side, and Dawn Run on the far side. Dawn Run from Seema as they race into the closing stages. It's Dawn Run from Seema, and as they come to the line, Dawn Run has won it from Seema, and very promising is third.
Desert Orchid started as a quietly fancied 7-1 shot, but found Cheltenham's left-handed course far from his liking and came home with disappointing 10th. He began the following season at Kempton with a third to run over and then took on the brilliant See You Then at Ascot.
Three from home, Northern Trial, Desert Orchid, See You Then coming there quite powerfully in behind them now, and then Joyride racing round the home turn, two flights left to jump, very little between Northern Trial and Desert Orchid, but See You Then and John Frankham still closing steadily with Joyride just behind him into the home stretch now. And it's Desert Orchid on the far side, Northern Trial on the near side, and coming between them by the look of it is See You Then. And See You Then coming there very strongly indeed, John Frankham. Desert Orchid on the far side. This is the second last flight. Desert Orchid going to land in the lead from See You Then, who jumps in second. Northern Trial dropping out of it. Joyride still trying to get on terms. But See You Then running the stronger now as they come to the final flight. See You Then from Desert Orchid on the far side. Joyride still in contention, but See You Then with the advantage at the last. See You Then and John Frankham jump it. Clear of Joyride in second. Desert Orchid third and racing into the closing stages. Joyride coming to put in a challenge over on the far side, but See You Then holding him. And at the line, See You Then is the winner, and Joyride is second, and third is Desert Orchid.
Desert Orchid renewed battle with See You Then in the Christmas hurdle, but Brown's Gazette was favourite.
So it's Desert Orchid as they begin the swing into the home straight in this Ladbroke Christmas hurdle, yet to be headed. Janus is second, Brown's Gazette third, Run over four, then See You Then five, a gap back to Stan's Pride and Rushmore, who are beginning to struggle. They begin the sweep for home. And Dermot Brown looks over to see where John Frankham is, and John Frankham's coming up on the inside of the chasing group as Dermot goes into second place behind Desert Orchid. So they're in line for home, they've got two to jump. It's Desert Orchid the grey, Brown's Gazette in yellow, then Janus in third, See You Then four, Run over five, two out. Good jump by Desert Orchid. Brown's Gazette getting ever closer and going quite sweetly. The third and fourth, John Frankham asks See You Then for extra effort. There's not a lot left in the locker. They've got just one more flight of hurdles to jump, but it's Brown's Gazette from Desert Orchid. Brown's Gazette cruising as he comes down towards the last. Brown's Gazette from Desert Orchid, See You Then back in third, come for the final flight, and he jumps it safely. It's Brown's Gazette from Desert Orchid, and then See You Then and Janus, the rest are struggling. This is a true championship performance, this, by Brown's Gazette.
It was also a terrific run by Desert Orchid, but after that he went to Ireland, where I thought the race came too soon for him. He was finished a dismal 13th in the Irish Sweeps hurdle, but then came back to form in the Otley hurdle.
It's Desert Orchid by five lengths to infielder, and then the pack are closing on him. They go to the last on the far side, and it's Desert Orchid on the inside from infielder, then Paddy's Bell and Amruller. Then Flary Sark just switched third from the right of the picture as Orten Glazed and Mr. Moonraker try to improve. But we home in on the leader, Desert Orchid, who's some four or five lengths clear as they turn out of the back straight. There's infielder and there's the chasing group. Amruller, Flary Sark and Mr. Moonraker. Brendan Powell just having to niggle and get into a drive position. These are clear from Orten Glazed, who's running disappointingly at this stage. And has Desert Orchid slipped his field? It's four to five clear as they turn into the home straight. It's Desert Orchid from infielder, Mr. Moonraker coming over to the stand side, squeezing out Flary Sark there, who just has to switch to the inner. They've got just over three furlongs to race, two more flights of hurdles to jump, and Desert Orchid, that 2-1 looking good at this stage, is from 4-5 clear from the gamble of the race, Mr. Moonraker, who's definitely closing as they come down to the second last. But it's Desert Orchid in the lead, comes to it, jumps it boldly and well. There's Mr. Moonraker in second place, Flary Sark is in third under pressure, Orten Glazed is staying on very well indeed. They've got one more flight of hurdles to jump, and stay-at-home punters must be wondering how they got a big price about Desert Orchid. As he skips over that, he's well clear from Mr. Moonraker and infielder, and then comes Flary Sark and Orten Glazed inside the final furlong. It's Desert Orchid by some 6-8 lengths. Desert Orchid, but he's tiring as they come up towards the line. Desert Orchid still 6-8 clear. Desert Orchid a long way clear, getting a tremendous reception as he comes up towards the post. Desert Orchid is the winner.
That victory gave Connections the confidence for a second attempt at the Champion Hurdle, but Desert Orchid was never travelling well, and it was the desperate going that took the blame and resulted in him being pulled up. Unfortunately, the same fate awaited him in the Welsh equivalent at Chepstow.
Well, Desert Orchid is still in front, but he's just beginning to come under pressure now, and Ranova's making ground on his outside, and Desert Orchid looks in trouble because Ranova is coming up to take the lead now from Desert Orchid, being rousted along by Colin Brown. The rest of the pack are closing as well, Brown's Gazette and Bajan Sunshine on the turn then. And Ranova from Desert Orchid in real trouble here. Bajan Sunshine's overtaken him, so too has Brown's Gazette. Sailor's Dance coming there on the inner.
The 1984-85 campaign finished with Desert Orchid falling in the Trillium Hurdle at Ascot, and exactly the same thing happened at the first race the following season in the Captain Quist Hurdle at Kempton. Again, he was clear when coming to grief at the final obstacle. Those falls may have been a blessing in disguise, for Desert Orchid was about to embark on his historic steeplechasing career, and he treated fences with a far healthier respect. David Ellsworth's decision to switch his rising star to chasing paid dividends from the start. Desi took to chasing like a duck to water when making all at Devon before tackling the unforgiving Ascot fences in the Hurst Park Novices Chase.
They come down to the third last. Desert Cocaine really motoring now as they race into the home turn. A long, long way clear of the remainder. Into the home turn, Desert Orchid, Cocaine. Cocaine just getting a little bit tired there. So they run down to the final fence in this Hurst Park Novices Chase. Desert Orchid, clear of Cocaine. Whee! Thought he was going to get close to that. Cocaine jumps it. And racing up to the line, Desert Orchid, what an attractive horse he is. Bowling past the winning post, the comfortable winner.
Desi won like a hot favourite should, and it appeared that he need only stand up to land the odds in Sandown's Henry II Chase.
As Desert Orchid comes down, ears pricked, to attack this, the third from home, the pond fence. Bold jump, very good jump indeed, and here now he should really draw away from Taffy Jones. And as they turn into the home straight, they've got just two to jump. It's the grey Desert Orchid in the lead from Taffy Jones in second, come down to two out. Another good jump from Taffy Jones in second. Bruton Match third, then racing back to Evening Song in four, and Amrunner just jumping in five. But one more fence to be jumped for Desert Orchid, who comes to it. A lovely bold jump clear from Taffy Jones in second, and Desert Orchid gets a well-deserved round of applause. Really never out of a canter here, and winning most impressively, most emphatically, coming up towards the line. Desert Orchid is the winner.
David Ellsworth's shrewd placing was giving Desert Orchid the experience he needed if he was to reach the very top over fences. Desi attempted the four-timer in Ascot's Killiney Novices Chase.
Number 11, Desert Orchid, really skips that one. He's very, very fast over his fences, this horse. Five from home, Desert Orchid. From Rhythmic Pastimes. Rhythmic just reducing that gap a little bit now. This is the final ditch, four from home. Desert Orchid from Rhythmic Pastimes jumps it fast and well in second. Evening Song is third. Playboy is out of it, bar any errors up front. Three from home. Oh, he nearly went there, Desert. He very nearly went. Brilliant recovery there by Colin Brown. But Rhythmic's under pressure too. So it looks bar a fall for Desert Orchid as he runs the home turn. Bar a fall, which he very nearly had at the third last. Desert Orchid coming to the second last now. Well cleared of Rhythmic Pastimes. Evening Song's under pressure. Desert jumps it well. Rhythmic jumps it second. And now Desert with just went one fence between he and victory in this Killarney Novices chase. He's a long way clear of Evening Song, just improved on Rhythmic Pastimes. This is the last fence. Desert Orchid just got to jump it. Ears pricked. Jumps it fine. Gets away from it well. Evening Song comes to jump it second. Rhythmic Pastimes third. And as they race to the line, Desert Orchid wins this Killarney Novices chase in very impressive style. Made just that one mistake at the third last, recovered very quickly.
That facile victory hinted at Des's increasing capacity to cope with longer trips, but after unseating his rider at Ascot, he took his chance in the 2 mile arkle chase over Cheltenham's testing left-handed track.
And Desert Orchid clear of Charco Wally, Berlin on the inside. On the outside of Berlin, River's Edge. Just behind them come Oregon Trail. And these five, a long way clear of the remainder, who are being headed by All Ten Glazed, beginning the run downhill now. And still, Desert Orchid, who's made all the running so far, from Charco Wally, Berlin on the inside. Then comes River's Edge, and then Oregon Trail. Music Be Magic was the faller out in the country. They're running down towards the next three from home now. Charco Wally coming to try and get on terms now with Desert Orchid. Then comes Oregon Trail on the outside of River's Edge, and then Berlin, who's making no progress at all now. And it's Charco Wally taking it up now from Desert Orchid. Four Auction was the faller there, coming down to the next, and it's two from home. Charco Wally from Desert Orchid. Then comes Oregon Trail racing round the home turn now. And as they do so, it's Charco Wally with the advantage from Oregon Trail, who's moved into second. Desert Orchid is third. Then comes River's Edge and Berlin, coming down to the final fence now in the Arco Challenge Trophy. And as they do so, Charco Wally lands in the lead from Oregon Trail on the far side. Desert Orchid is third. Four and five, River's Edge and Berlin racing into the closing stages. Charco Wally being pressed all the time by Oregon Trail. Charco Wally on the near side, Oregon Trail on the far side. Oregon Trail is getting up at the line. Oregon Trail has just run it from Charco Wally with third, Desert Orchid and four, River's Edge.
Desi had still never won going left-handed and failed to score in his final two races of the season. The 1986-87 campaign began in Sandown's 2.5 mile lager chase.
And Desert Orchid just steadied again in front. I think Colin Brown really riding a brainy sort of race. He's absolutely dictating the pace, it seems to me. And over that ditch, and Okrabora, who is last and out of your picture, well, in now, really climbed over that open ditch. So the leaders now go on to the water jump, the only water jump in the race. It's fence number 11, Desert Orchid. Again, jumps it well, very promising within half a length or so now on the outside. Behind the two and in third, a very close third, is still the Argonaut, and it's clearly now a three-horse race. These three have gone miles clear of the outsider, Okrabora. Desert Orchid over in front, flew that one, followed by Very Promising and the Argonaut in that order. Two more to take over on the far side. Desert Orchid again jumped it well, a bit of a mistake on the outside by Very Promising. Richard Dunwoody held him together though nicely, then the Argonaut in third, and that's the order with Okrabora. Still has that fence to jump on the far side. He's a fence behind now, Okrabora. So these three principals still led by Desert Orchid, who's yet to be headed. He's made all so far, leading from Very Promising, the joint favorite in second, and then the Argonaut, who's close up in the betting of 5-2 or thereabouts, third favorite, very close in third place. Now they're running towards the final three fences in this Holston Export Lager handicap chase. Desert Orchid the Grey still out in front under Colin Brown, then Very Promising, Richard Dunwoody. And Richard really hasn't moved a muscle either on Very Promising. They jumped this one well, half a length down they were to Desert Orchid. The Argonaut still well there in contention in third. Now the pressure's going to be on as they race round the home turn and come to the second from home. Just two to go here at Sand. Now Desert Orchid the Grey is going to jump it first. He does, from Very Promising. Now the Argonaut being produced for his effort. He'll be challenging over on the inside of Desert Orchid. The chairs go up from the stands. This is going to be another nail-biting finish. Desert Orchid being pressed now by the Argonaut. Desert Orchid over first. The Argonaut second. Very Promising's not going to win this one. He's back in third. And the Argonaut coming with a great run, but he's not going to catch Desert Orchid. Desert Orchid is going to reappear with a win once more, like he did two seasons ago. Up to the line and at the post is Desert Orchid the winner.
It appeared that the older Desert Orchid got, the longer the trip he needed. Desi could finish only fourth at Ascot before returning to that same Berkshire course 1 month later for the Frogmore Handicap.
Desert Orchid being joined by Farbridge, only a length then to Charcoal Wally, another length or less to Annette's Delight, then Our Fun closing up in fifth, followed by St. William and Little Bay as they go to the seventh fence. Desert Orchid on the inside, Charcoal Wally on the outside, Farbridge between them, and they've got five to jump now. Charcoal Wally on the far side, Desert Orchid on the near side, then Annette's Delight, Farbridge, then all close up now are St. William, Our Fun and Little Bay. This is the last ditch, four from home, and Desert Orchid and Charcoal Wally took it together. St. William made a mistake. Little Bay still going very well just in behind the leaders as they go to the third last. Desert Orchid from Charcoal Wally and Annette's Delight. Nothing between the three. Then Little Bay improving to dispute fourth with Our Fun. Then Farbridge, who looks out of it, and then St. William, who does as well. But in the straight, and it's Annette's Delight now. Annette's Delight disputing it with Charcoal Wally. Then Desert Orchid still close up in third. Little Bay and Our Fun come next at the second last. Annette's Delight from Desert Orchid renewing his challenge. So is Charcoal Wally. And they've both gone past Annette's Delight now. And it's Desert Orchid on the far side from Charcoal Wally. Annette's Delight. Then comes Our Fun staying on. Then Little Bay, who's not finding any more, but Desert Orchid has gone clear at the last. Jumps it well. Desert Orchid has a clear lead from the other grey, Charcoal Wally. Then Annette's Delight, but going to the line. An impressive win for Desert Orchid, with Charcoal Wally staying on to hold second place. It's going to be close for third between Little Bay and Annette's Delight. Then comes Our Fun, St. William and Farbridge.
Desert Orchid was an unfancied 16-1 shot for Kempton's King George VI Chase, a race second only in stature to the Cheltenham Gold Cup.
Well, between them, they've won 111 races and over £667,000 in winning prize money, and they're on their way for the King George VI ranked chase. 3 miles, 19 fences to jump. Desert Orchid, the grey, leads from Dorlach, and then with the stripe sleeves, Bow Ranger, they come to the first, which the leaders skip over. And they're all over the first. Forgive and Forget in last place and settled well. Desert Orchid, the leader, as they come to the first ditch. Desert Orchid in the lead from Dorlach. And Forgive and Forget didn't get very high there at the rear of the field. And Desert Orchid leads as they turn into the back straight. Desert Orchid from Dorlach, Bow Ranger, Boland's Cross. And then Wayward Lad, Western Sunset, Coombs Ditch and Forgive and Forget at the back of the field together with Von Trapp. Those are the last three. But it's Coombs Ditch's stable companion, Desert Orchid, who's 6 to 8 lengths clear as they go down towards the third. A plain fence. Desert Orchid by 10 lengths to Dorlach, by 5 lengths to Bow Ranger, by a length and a half to Boland's Cross, by 6 lengths to Wayward Lad, and then the other four close up behind them. Western Sunset, Forgive and Forget, jumped that one better, warming to his task. Coombs Ditch and Von Trapp the back two. This is the second ditch that the leader comes to, and Desert Orchid jumps it well. From Dorlach second, and then Boland's Cross in third, and Bow Ranger four, and Wayward Lad five. Forgive and Forget, and Western Sunset, and Von Trapp, and Coombs Ditch. And the leader is a long way clear, and it's Desert Orchid who comes to it. Jumps it well, some 12 lengths clear now. Boland's Cross and Dorlach. Coombs Ditch is the back marker. And it's Desert Orchid clear as they come towards the sixth, the plain fence. Desert Orchid clear by 10 lengths to Boland's Cross, who didn't jump that as well as Dorlach, who goes through to second place now. So it's Desert Orchid in the lead as they swing out of the back straight. Desert Orchid clear from Dorlach in second, Boland's Cross is third, Wayward Lad is four, then Bow Ranger five, Forgive and Forget, Western Sunset, Von Trapp and Coombs Ditch are all bunched up behind the leading four. And it's Desert Orchid who is well clear, and there you can see the chasing group all playing cat and mouse with each other. And it's Desert Orchid who's clear of Dorlach in second. This is the seventh fence they come to. It's a plain fence. All the three in the home straight are plain. Desert Orchid comes to it, jumps it safely. Dorlach in second, and then comes Boland's Cross third, and Wayward Lad and Western Sunset, and Forgive and Forget and Coombs Ditch going the shortest way. And this is the eighth. And it's Desert Orchid who leads from Dorlach in second, and Boland's Cross is third, and Wayward Lad four. Western Sunset five, and then Bow Ranger and Von Trapp, and Forgive and Forget, and Coombs Ditch. And this is the ninth they're coming to now. A plain fence. Desert Orchid in the lead. Desert Orchid Prime in second place, Dorlatch. Desert Orchid, Dorlatch, Berlin's Cross, and Wayward Lad. And Forgive and Forget didn't jump that too well, but safely enough. And so John Oaksey with the circuit to go, 10 to jump. Desert Orchid has come back to his field now.
Yes, he's a little bit closer, but that doesn't mean he's tired. His ears are pricked, he's perfectly happy, and he's jumping superbly. The favourite, Forgive and Forget, has made several mistakes. That is his habit, really. He very often does make mistakes. Mark Dwyer has survived them all so far, as he usually does. But the question is, how far dare these fellows let Desert Orchid go? Because David Ellsworth doesn't think he'll come back to them. And, well, I'm not so sure myself. He's going awfully well at the moment. Dorlatch still going well in second place. Boland's Cross in third. And Wayward Lad, who's been jumping superbly, in fourth. As they start out on the last circuit, well, it's all still very much to play for. Look at that leap.
Second last ditch they've just taken there, and Bow Ranger has been pulled up. It's Desert Orchid in the lead from Dorlatch in second, and Boland's Cross third. And now Forgive and Forget has gone through into fourth place, with Wayward Lad fifth, and then Coombs Ditch. And so Forgive and Forget, the 2-1 favourite, Coombs Ditch at 4-1, Boland's Cross at 9-2, as they level up into the back stretch, and they've got seven more fences to jump. So it's Desert Orchid by four lengths to Dorlatch, by three lengths to Boland's Cross, by three lengths to Wayward Lad, to a neck Forgive and Forget, then a length to Western Sunset, then Coombs Ditch, and Von Trapp finding his pace just a bit hot now. There's seven from home, and Desert Orchid skips over it in the lead from Dorlatch second, Boland's Cross Novice in third, Forgive and Forget is four, Coombs Ditch makes ground on the inside of Wayward Lad, and they've got six to jump. And it's Desert Orchid in the lead by four lengths. Desert Orchid jumps it well. Dorlatch in second, Boland's Cross third, Coombs Ditch now four, Forgive and Forget with that one, and then comes Wayward Lad, and the big powerful three closing on, but Wayward Lad is having to be ridden to get into his position, and it's Desert Orchid who leads. Desert Orchid over in the lead from Dorlatch second and Boland's Cross and Coombs Ditch, and then comes Forgive and Forget with plenty to do, and Wayward Lad with plenty to do. So they begin the sweep out of the back stretch, having jumped that one. Desert Orchid leads, that's the fourth from home. Desert Orchid by eight lengths now to Dorlatch in second, Coombs Ditch is third, then comes Forgive and Forget and Boland's Cross, and Wayward Lad with a lot to do on the extreme left of the picture gets a reminder to go about his business. And it's Desert Orchid who's still clear, but here comes Forgive and Forget, the class horse in the race. Mark Dwyer now switched to the outside of Dorlatch, Coombs Ditch back in fourth, Boland's Cross, and then Wayward Lad, and they're in line for home. It's Desert Orchid, and Simon Sherwood look round to see who the chasers are, and the chaser is the top chaser in the country. It's Forgive and Forget, they've got three to jump. It's Desert Orchid, Forgive and Forget, then comes Dorlatch, followed by Boland's Cross and Coombs Ditch, and Wayward Lad won't be winning, but Desert Orchid is in the clear lead as it comes down towards the second last. It's Desert Orchid over safely from Forgive and Forget, the top chaser in the country, held in second place. Dorlatch is third, Boland's Cross four, Coombs Ditch is being pulled up, but it's his stable companion Desert Orchid who's clear as they come down toward the 19th and final fence in this King George VI ranked steeplechase. At the last, Desert Orchid jumps it well. Desert Orchid clear from Forgive and Forget and Dorlatch as they race up toward the line. It's Desert Orchid for an amazing pillar to post win in this top class chase. Desert Orchid comes home well clear. At the post, Desert Orchid is the winner.
That spectacular trailblazing victory catapulted Desert Orchid into the limelight, but there were some who thought it was a fluke. But it was the start of Desi Mania.
Going to the water jump for the final time, and Desert Orchid quickening up on the inside. But Boland's Cross and Steersby and Charter Party and Catchphrase as they take the water, and Boland's Cross makes a mistake there. And Boland's Cross loses valuable lengths, goes back to fourth place as they go to the sixth from home. But it's Desert Orchid in the lead from Steersby closing in second, and Steersby still got off that a long way. Boland's Cross now gets back into contention, goes back into second place. Desert Orchid in the lead from Boland's Cross and Charter Party and Steersby being rode along by Graham McCourt. Last on the far side, Desert Orchid in the lead from, in second place, Steersby, and then in third is Boland's Cross, and then comes Charter Party and Catchphrase. And really, you need to set Steersby alight. The one thing that horse does do is stay, and this 3-mile trip may not be far enough for him, but if he can keep up the hill, he's got a pace horse to beat in Desert Orchid, who's going for home, and they've got three to jump, and it's Desert Orchid showing the way to Steersby in second, and Boland's Cross back in third, and Charter Party, and indeed Richard Rowe trying to come up on the inside on Catchphrase. but it's Desert Orchid in the lead from Bolan's Cross, who's trying to cap on the inner. Steersby's back in third place and looking one pace as they jump three out. And Steersby makes a mistake there, and they've got just two to jump now. And it's Desert Orchid, unproven at the trip on this track, in the lead and quickly goes clear. Colin Brown's used a bit of speed to get four lengths advantage on the others as they come down towards the second last. He jumps it well, and their Charter Party falls and hampers Bolan's Cross. Horse and jockey are okay. They've got one fence to jump, and it's Desert Orchid who's six lengths clear of Steersby in second place. And as they come to the last, Desert Orchid comes to it, and he pings it well. A tremendous roar from the crowd, and Desert Orchid storms up the hill. Steersby's in second place, Bolan's Cross is back in third, Catchphrase in four, and Desert Orchid, the top weight, getting a tremendous reception. He's going to win this, and at the post, Desert Orchid, pat on the neck from Colin Brown. He's done it well.
And that win earned Desert Orchid a place in the Queen Mother Chase at Cheltenham, a course at which he had yet to win.
Milesian Dancer, Townley Stone, Little Bay just the back marker, the first of the ditches. And Little Bay faller there. Little Bay has gone at the first ditch. He's up all right, the winningmost horse in the race he was when he set out. He's up all right. And over the eighth, it was Desert Orchid from Captain Dawn. Very promising, and Charco Wally. Then Pearly Man and Townley Stone coming to the final ditch now. Milesian Dance is the back marker. This is four from home. The two greys now disputing it. And it's Desert Orchid and Charco Wally from Very Promising and Pearly Man. A beautiful jump in fourth place, goes up into third now. Townley Stone comes next, and behind him is Captain Dawn, who's lost a lot of ground. And now it's Desert Orchid with three to jump. Charco Wally on his inside, then Very Promising, then Pearly Man going strongly in fourth, Townley Stone in five. And the rest are virtually out of it now as they come down towards the next with Desert Orchid. Charco Wally, Very Promising between horses. On the far side, Townley Stone and Pearly Man still going strongly in behind them as they come down to the next. Desert Orchid lands three out in the lead from Very Promising. Pearly Man's improving between horses. Under pressure, Townley Stone over on the far side, coming down towards the second last now. And it's Desert Orchid in the lead from Very Promising. Pearly Man, Townley Stone, Desert Orchid from Very Promising. Pearly Man in third. Four is Townley Stone and five is Charco Wally. They're rounding the home turn now with just one fence to jump in the Queen Mother Champion Chase, and it's Very Promising who's taking it up from the white pace. Pearly Man. Pearly Man coming to take the lead at the final fence now. It's Pearly Man with the advantage of Very Promising on the far side. Pearly Man lands in the lead from Very Promising. Desert Orchid fighting back towards the near side. It's Pearly Man in the center. Very Promising on the far side. Pearly Man and Very Promising. There's nothing between the two as they race up towards the line. Very Promising is fighting back. Pearly Man on the near side as they come to the line. It's going to be a photo. Pearly Man has just won it from Very Promising. Pearly Man, the winner. Very Promising second. Third was Desert Orchid.
Desi found the specialist two-miler Pearly Man too sharp for him there, and the handicapper did his best to anchor the White Tornado at Ascot.
Desert Orchid in the lead from Soxdown, Sign Again, then Fudge Light and Gilbert and Clara Mountain, and Chief Ironside, that I've been calling General Ironside. Rather sticky there was Clara Mountain. Now coming to the sixth, will be the last on the next circuit. Desert Orchid comes to it, about three lengths clear of Soxdown. Lands clear. Fudgelite jumps a third, Goldbearer, Chief Ironside, Sign Again, and Clara Mountain. So passing the winning post on the first circuit, Desert Orchid from Soxdown, Chief Ironside, Goldbearer, Fudgelite, Sign Again, and Clara Mountain. Desert Orchid on this rain-soaked ground, about an eight-length leader now from Soxdown, then Chief Ironside, Sign Again and Goldbearer, Clara Mountain, then Fudge Delight now the back marker as they race round this turn with a mile and a half to run and run towards number seven, Desert Orchid. Lands clear of Soxdown, Chief Ironside, Sign Again, Goldbearer, Fudge Delight, and Clara Mountain. Another plain one before the second of the ditches. Number eight, Desert Orchid, clear of Soxdown, Chief Ironside, Sign Again, Goldbearer, mistake there by Fudge Delight, and running to this ditch now. Number nine, Desert Orchid, clear at the moment of Soxdown, Chief Ironside, Gold Bearer, Sign Again, Clara Mountain and Fudge Delight. Running to the water. Desert Orchid. Under a mile to run. Clears it from Soxdown, Gold Bearer, Chief Ironside, Sign Again, Fudge Delight getting closer now, then Clara Mountain. Six left to jump now and a long run to the next in this Peregrine handicap chase with Desert Orchid clear of Gold Bearer, who now goes second just ahead of Soxdown. Fudge Delight's improving in fourth, then Sign Again, Chief Ironside and Clara Mountain. Desert Orchid over the 11th from Gold Bearer second, third Soxdown, fourth Fudge Delight improving. Soxdown beginning to close, five out on Desert Orchid, who's still jumping brilliantly. Fudge Delight's moved into third, racing now towards the final ditch. Desert Orchid, four out, being pressed by Gold Bearer now. Desert Orchid and Gold Bearer. Gold Bearer lands in the lead. It's Gold Bearer now from Desert Orchid. Fudge Delight has moved into third. Gold Bearer with a four-length advantage coming to this third last from Desert Orchid. Gold Bearer lands clear. Desert Orchid trying to fight back. Fudge Delight some way back in third. But it's Gold Bearer with only 10 stone and Guy Landor claiming the £4 allowance. And Desert Orchid with 12 stone four as they've got two fences left to jump. Gold Bearer and Guy Landor, who gave Lanerai such a great ride in the National, with the advantage from Desert Orchid, who's trying to fight back at the second last. Gold Bearer lands in the lead from Desert Orchid, getting closer again, coming down to the last, and it's Gold Bearer with Desert Orchid getting a great cheer from the crowd as he battles back and tries to get on terms once again, coming to the final fence in the Peregrine chase. And Desert Orchid has taken it up again and is going to jump the last in the lead. It's Desert Orchid from Gold Bearer at the final fence. Desert Orchid lands in the lead, Gold Bearer second, racing into the closing stage. Desert Orchid from Gold Bearer. Gold Bearer's challenging again. Sign Again's trying to get on terms as well, but Desert Orchid is holding him and he's going to win it. Desert Orchid has won his 17th race, his 10th chase. Second was Gold Bearer, third Sign Again.
There is now just one natural target for Desert Orchid, the Whitbread Gold Cup at Sandown. All eyes were on the Flying Grey as they raced down the far side, but Colin Brown was never happy on him and finally pulled him up. It was subsequently disclosed that Desert Orchid had been troubled by a corn in his foot since the Ascot win. This had been cut out and connections wrongly believed that the problem had been solved. Well, although he was pulled up in the Whitbread Gold Cup, he still managed to win six races and was third in the Queen Mother Champion Chase. Desert Orchid started 7-1 on for his first race of the 87-88 season, the Terry Biddlecombe Chase at Wincanton, and duly won as he liked. Des's next race was the Rank Boxing Day trial, where the competition was just as poor. Sandown's Tingle Creek Chase may have been Des's third race of the season, but it was his first real taste of competition. He was conceding almost two stones to long engagement.
So they continue their journey down the far side and head towards the three island fences, with Farbridge leading from Desert Orchid. Desert Orchid moving up on the inside, that's the left of the picture. Got a bit close to that one. Farbridge, Ambler, Rambler makes ground on the outside. Summerled makes a mistake and gets a reminder for his pains. This is the ninth, and there, three virtually in line, were Desert Orchid, Farbridge and Ambler Rambler on the outside. Long Engagement tucked away in fourth, and at that one, little to choose between Farbridge and Desert Orchid. Long Engagement getting closer on the inside of Ambler Rambler. The only one really not in contention is Summerled, but as they turn out of the back straight, it's Desert Orchid who asserts and now goes on by a clear length. But look at Long Engagement in the striped jacket, the dark striped jacket next to the rails. Farbridge gets a reminder there. Ambler Rambler looks for room. They come down towards the third last, and it's Desert Orchid in the lead from Farbridge, who's being hard ridden. Long Engagement, the big challenger to Desert Orchid. Ambler Rambler on the right, come down towards the third last. Four virtually in line. What a race in prospect here. Desert Orchid in the lead from long engagement in second. What a good jump by Desert Orchid when he needed it most. Desert Orchid from long engagement. Then comes Farbridge, and Ambler Rambler is finding his pace too hot. But it's Desert Orchid in the lead with a challenge coming from long engagement, who's receiving two stone. And long engagement now comes to take Desert Orchid. Can Desert Orchid find more? But long engagement now quickens up on the outside of Desert Orchid, who comes under pressure. And long engagement in receipt of two stone draws four lengths clear as they come to the last. Long engagement meets it well. Desert Orchid made it running, and he's trying to stay on up the hill. But long engagement has a superior turn of foot, and up towards the line, long engagement's going to win. And long engagement clear from Desert Orchid. So long engagement gets the most important scalp yet. Long engagement the winner, Desert Orchid second.
Desert Orchid then attempted to win Kempton's King George VI chase for the second year running.
And Colin Brown got the inside on Desert Orchid towards the left of the picture. Bow Ranger's with him, and don't forget Cy Brandian can certainly force a pace too. These three have it as they come to the first of the 19 fences, and they're in the air together, they touch down together. Forgive and Forget is four, Napsala five, and Golden Friend and Bowland's Cross, and the two castles, Andrea and Warden, are at the back. They come to the second, this is the first ditch, and Bow Ranger stood on here. Studied off from it a very long way indeed. The pace is extraordinarily hot, and there's a lot of daylight between those three up front, and it's Bow Ranger and Desert Orchid and Cy Brandian now has given up the unequal struggle of really forcing this pace, but they're 15 lengths clear of Forgive and Forget. They've only jumped two fences. Napsala is in fifth place, then comes Golden Friend, Berlin's Cross, and the two castles. So they turn into the back straight, they come down towards the third, and on the inside it's Desert Orchid who leads. Desert Orchid the leader from Bow Ranger and Cy Brandian on the right, and this is the third. They come to it, Desert Orchid from Bow Ranger and Cy Brandian, then Forgive and Forget and Napsala and Golden Friend and Berlin's Cross and Castle Warden and Castle Andrea is tailed off. Now this is the second, and it's a ditch, and they come to it, and Bow Ranger has it from Cy Brandian and Desert Orchid, 10 clear of Napsala, who goes into 4, Forgive and Forget 5. They race down towards the 5th of the 19 they take, and Bow Ranger now has won the fight for the lead. Bow Ranger leads by three parts of a length from, in second place, Cy Brandian, Desert Orchid. There go Forgive and Forget. That was Berlin's Cross in the red, and the towed off horse is almost a fence behind already. They're coming down to the 6th, and it's Bow Ranger in the lead from Cy Brandian, and that's some idea of the chasing group as Napsala goes through into third. So it's Bow Ranger in the lead from Cy Brandian in second and Desert Orchid in third, and they're 15 lengths clear of Napsala and Forgive and Forget. They're 20 lengths clear of Bowland's Cross and Golden Friend, who is 5 lengths clear of Castle Warden, who's a distance clear of Castle Andrea, and they turn into the home straight and they come towards the 7th. Really a breathtaking pace here set by Bow Ranger from Cy Brandian and Desert Orchid, but Forgive and Forget now getting a bit closer, and Napsala is in fifth, and this is the seventh, and the leaders are over, and Forgive and Forget and Napsala. Then comes Golden Friend and Bowland's Cross. They come down towards the eighth, and it's Bow Ranger on the outside of Desert Orchid. Then comes Cy Brandian. Behind these comes Forgive and Forget, then Napsala, then the other three, Golden Friend and Castle Warden and Bowland's Cross, Castle Andrea tailed off. This will be the last next time round. The pace really furious. The grey, of course, Desert Orchid on the left, got the inside from the start. Bow Ranger on the outside of inside. Brandian is in third. And John Oakes, they've gone so fast over this first mile. Can they keep it up?
I just hope they haven't gone too fast, John.
Yeah, they've gone an extraordinarily quick gallop. Colin Brown, I think, would like to have been in front, and he's tried to stay upside with Desert Orchid. But Bow Ranger looks like far the happiest going at this pace, and it's very difficult to see anything beating him at the moment. They're a long way from home, yeah. But he seems to be coping with this pace better than anything else.
He's sometimes been out jumping Desert Orchid. Desert Orchid hasn't been jumping at his very best yet, but the race is only just beginning.
Well, at the 11th of the 19 fences, and Forgive and Forget, the horse with the noseband, that one's back in fourth place, but Bow Ranger leads from Desert Orchid in second as they go towards the second last ditch, and Desert Orchid comes into it, jumps it well, Cy Brandian third, Forgive and Forget, Napsala, and there Berlin's Cross fell, the jockeys rolled away, the horse will be getting up shortly, and they turn into the back straight, and it's Desert Orchid on the inside, but Bow Ranger has it by a couple of lengths. Bow Ranger from Desert Orchid, and Forgive and Forget, the Gold Cup winner, and now perhaps appreciated that fantastically fast pace. He's picking up and starting to run, and he's closing in third, Cy Brandian, then the French runner Napsala. So they've got seven more fences to jump, and it's Bow Ranger in the lead from Desert Orchid, then Forgive and Forget, then Cy Brandian, then Castle Warden, followed then on the outside by Nupsala, the French runner at the jockey in the green jacket, and that was the seventh from home. Desert Orchid moves up on the inside of Bow Ranger. Forgive and Forget is closing in third. Then Nupsala is four and Cybrandy in five. The one that's tailed off is Castle Andrea. This is the last ditch, and Bow Ranger just didn't mean it quite right. Desert Orchid meant the better. Cybrandy in a crashing fall there, and Desert Orchid goes into the lead as they race down with just five more fences to jump. And the French horse is going well too in fourth place, but they've got to capture one in front. Is Desert Orchid, and he met that one flying, and Bow Ranger is second, and on the outside Nupsala goes well in third. Forgive and Forget four, they come down towards the fourth from home, and Desert Orchid in the lead. Desert Orchid met it well from in second place. Nupsala, who's weaved through between them to challenge in second place. And so as they turn into the home straight, that was Cybrandy and Roddy Beck, and he's okay. But they turn into the home straight with three to jump, and the French raider Nepsala is going ominously well as Desert Orchid is out in front, and he's leading, but only by half a length. Nepsala is second. Then comes Bow Ranger on the outside third. Behind these, Forgive and Forget is in fourth place. We've got a real race in prospect as the French go on. Nepsala pulling double on the outside of Desert Orchid. What reserves can Desert Orchid find? Three out. Desert Orchid jump well. Nupsala goes on, and Desert Orchid looks beaten. Forgive and Forget back in third place. They come down towards the second last, and Nupsala leads. Desert Orchid can find no more. Bow Ranger makes a mistake. They've just got one more fence to jump, and Nupsala, the French challenger, out in the lead. And now the Gold Cup challenger, Forgive and Forget, is the only challenger. Desert Orchid is beaten in third. They come to the last. Nupsala on the left, and Forgive and Forget falls. Desert Orchid is left second. But this King George six-round chase has been presented to France in the form of Nupsala, who comes 15 lengths clear. And at the line, Nupsala is the winner. Nupsala the winner. Desert Orchid finishes second.
Desert Orchid and Bow Ranger had cut each other's throats there. Desi was then set to concede lumps of weight to subsequent Gold Cup winner Charter Party.
Desert Orchid leads by a length and a half. To run and skip, and then coming up into third is Charter Party. These are followed by Foil Fisherman and All Ten Glaze. And Chief Ironside and Rhyme and Reason. Queensway Boy and Sun Rising are really struggling now. I think Queensway Boy might well be pulling up as they continue their journey down the far side. And it's Desert Orchid from Run and Skip, Charter Party. Then All Ten Glaze, Foil Fisherman, Chief Ironside on the wide outside. Rhyme and Reason getting closer on the left of the picture. That's the 18th. And there All Ten Glaze made a bad mistake. But it's Desert Orchid the leader now by a length and a half. To Run and Skip in second, Charter Party and Chief Ironside and All Ten Glaze and Foil Fisherman and Rhyme and Reason. And they begin the turn for home, and it's Desert Orchid who leads, but Charter Party is travelling ominously well for the supporters of Desert Orchid, with Run and Skip in third, a gap opening up of four lengths then to Rhyme and Reason as the pace is turned on again. All Ten Glazed and Chief Ironside try to get a contention, but it's the grey Desert Orchid being tackled now by Charter Party. They've got three to jump in the Gainsborough handicap, and coming down towards the 20th fence, it's Desert Orchid with Charter Party travelling well on the outside, a length and a half back to Run and Skip, but Desert Orchid puts a good jump in there, and Desert Orchid goes on, but Charter Party can answer with every call. Charter Party now the challenger to Desert Orchid. They're four clear of Run and Skip and Rhyme and Reason, and Desert Orchid gets a reminder as Charter Party comes the second last where he fell last year, jumps it well this, and Charter Party disputes it with Desert Orchid. They're five clear of Rhyme and Reason as they power down towards the 22nd and final fence, and Charter Party goes on by length. Charter Party and Desert Orchid, who will not be denied at the last, they're in the air together, they touch down together, but Charter Party has the better jump and goes on by two lengths, by three lengths. Two in second place, Desert Orchid, and Charter Party storms clear, and Desert Orchid could well be beaten by a stable companion, Rhyme and Reason, for a place, but Charter Party has it at the line, and Charter Party wins. Rhyme and Reason pips Desert Orchid for second and third.
After that, Desert Orchid took on the enigmatic Kildemo and the 1984 Gold Cup hero, Borough Hill Lad.
So they're coming down to the cross fence, four from home here. Desert Orchid by a length to Kildemo and Borough Hill Lad together. So Desert Orchid on the home turn has about a length lead from Kildemo in the centre. Borough Hill Lad still breathing down their necks on the outside. All to play for then as they come down to the third last. Desert Orchid by a length from Kildemo, still travelling very well in the centre, and Borough Hill Lad running a great race on his reappearance on the outside. But Desert Orchid is going to jump the third last. just in front, Desert Orchid, from Kildemo in the centre, being rousted now by Graham Bradley, and Desert Orchid from Kildemo as they come to the second last. Desert Orchid lands about a length clear from Kildemo, but Kildemo still going well in the centre, and taking it up now, Kildemo, as they come to the last. Kildemo jumps it just from Desert Orchid in second, and Desert Orchid looks beaten. He's trying to rally on the far side, but Kildemo is holding him as they come out towards the line. Kildemo wins it from Desert Orchid in second.
Desi's Cheltenham Festival target was again the Queen Mother Champion Chase. He was still trying to dispel that left-handed hoodoo.
This is the first of the ditches now. Desert Orchid lands clear of Panto Prince, who jumps it second. Weather the Storm third, very promising, and Pearly Man together, then Midnight Count on the outside, then Long Engagement, then Super Furrow. Another plain one now, the eighth, before the final ditch. And Desert Orchid there from Panto Prince in second. Weather the Storm is third, 4, 5, and 6, a Long Engagement. Very promising, and Pearly Man, and then Midnight Count and Super Furrow. And with his lead reduced to about 5 lengths now, Desert Orchid comes to the last ditch. 4 from home. Desert Orchid lands in the lead of Panto Prince. Weather the Storm is third. Long Engagement 4. Pearly Prince 5, 6, very promising. 7 is Midnight Count. 8 and last and under pressure is Super Furrow as they begin to run downhill now with 3 left to jump in the Queen Mother Champion Chase, and Desert Orchid, the grey, in the lead as they come down the hill from Panto Prince on the right of the picture. Weather the Storm going well just in behind them. Then comes Very Promising and Long Engagement. In the center of the picture, Desert Orchid. On the right is Panto Prince. The gray, then another gray. Weather the Storm in third. Pearly Man going very well just in behind Desert Orchid now, Very Promising being hard ridden towards the right of the picture as they come down to the second last. Desert Orchid on the left, Pearly Man and Panto Prince to the right, a mistake there by Very Promising. They're racing now to the final turn now, and Tom Morgan looks round as Pearly Prince, last year's winner, Pearly Man, storms into the lead. It's Pearly Man as they race towards the final fence now in the Queen Mother Champion Chase. Pearly Man with Very Promising renewing his challenge. But Pearly Man with his white face is going to jump it 2 lengths of the lead. Pearly Man from Very Promising. Desert Orchid renewing his challenge. This is a carbon copy of last year, except that Pearly Man is going to win it much more easily as they race up towards the line. Pearly Man has it well sewn up. Desert Orchid is challenging Very Promising for second place, and at the line, Pearly Man is the winner. Desert Orchid just gets up to be second ahead of Very Promising third, and Midnight Counter strong finishing fourth. That's the 1, 2, 3, 4 in the Queen Mother Champion Chase.
Again, Perlyman was too quick for him, and his win Canton Conqueror Kildemo was made favourite to beat Desi round the left-handed turns of Liverpool.
18 fences to be jumped, just the 4 runners now. Contradeal and Desert Orchid. Desert Orchid leading Contradeal, then Kildemo and Weather the Storm as they come to the first of the 18. Desert Orchid lands clear of Contradeal, Weather the Storm and Kildemo. Desert Orchid never yet won on a left-hand course, bidding to do so for the first time today to win his 20th race. Lands clear of Contradeal and Kildemo and Weather the Storm. And now the one grand national obstacle in the race, the water. Number 3 this time, number 16 in the national, and Desert Orchid comes to it well clear of Contradeal, Kildemo and Weather the Storm. Desert Orchid by about 10 lengths now from Contradeal, Kildemo and then Weather the Storm. And a very disappointed Peter Scudamore leading Bow Ranger back after the horse had been withdrawn through spreading a print. And Desert Orchid, ears pricked. Simon Sherwood comes to the fourth from Contradeal, Kildemo and Weather the Storm. Desert Orchid clear of Contradeal, Kildemo and Weather the Storm. Another plain one before the first of the ditches. Desert Orchid from Contradeal, Kildemo and Weather the Storm. just a fraction of hesitation there and part of the gray before he took that. But he's still clear. We see him towards the left of the picture, Contradeal towards the right, behind Desert Orchid is Kildymo, and then Weather the Storm, the back marker. And now making their way towards the home turn on the first circuit, Desert Orchid from Contradeal and Kildymo and Weather the Storm. And Simon Sherwood on the 49 mark rides Vorderberg in the National, being followed by Kevin Mooney on Contradeal, then Graham Bradley as they jump the seventh on Kildymo, and finally Tom Taff, who rides Mona Noor in the National on the Irish challenger Mona Noor. There's an Orchid from Contradeal, Kildymo, and getting closer to them, Weather the Storm. That was a ditch. Number nine, Desert Orchid from Contradeal and Kildymo and Weather the Storm. Desert Orchid has made it all so far. Once again, not showing great freedom at that fence, but negotiating it all right. Contradeal and Kildymo come next, and then Weather the Storm, and now the water, of course, for the last time. Number 11 of the 18 fences, Desert Orchid, jumps clear of Contradeal and Kildymo, and Weather the Storm. Now, a complete circuit in this Chivas Regal Cup chase. Seven left to jump. Desert Orchid, winner of 19 of his 46 races, bidding to win left-handed for the first time in his career. Followed by Contradeal and Kildymo, and then Weather the Storm as he comes to the next. Jumps that beautifully. Kildymo and Contradeal stride for stride, and then Weather the Storm. Another plain one, and then they come to the penultimate ditch. Six out, Desert Orchid, from Kildymo, Contradeal, and Weather the Storm. Desert Orchid. Five from home, clear of Kildymo. Weather the Storm makes a mistake there, goes through it. Contradeal didn't jump it too well either. Desert Orchid with a 10-length advantage, at least over Kildymo, trying to get on terms. Weather the Storm has gone third, Contradeal four. So racing now towards the fourth last in this Chivas Regal Cup chase. And the grey, Desert Orchid and Simon Sherwood with a good 8-length advantage over Kildymo. Jumps that beautifully. Kildymo second. Weather the Storm getting closer in third. This is the final ditch now. Three from home. Desert Orchid being pursued by Kildymo and Weather the Storm at the final ditch. Desert Orchid by about 5 lengths from Kildymo. Weather the Storm in third. Coming down to the second last now. Desert Orchid from Kildymo and Weather the Storm. At the second last, Desert Orchid lands about 5 lengths clear of Kildymo, then Weather the Storm. Racing to the final fence now. Simon Sherwood looks over his right shoulder, sees that Kildymo is the danger as he comes down to the final fence. Desert Orchid lands in the lead about 4 to 5 lengths clear of Kildymo, and he's getting a tremendous reception from the crowd. This immensely popular grey, he's going to win left-handed for the first time in his life. He's going to win his 20th race too. Desert Orchid strides up to the line to tremendous applause from the entry crowd here. He's won the Chivas Regal Stakes and second Kildymo, and third was Weather the Storm.
That easy victory set Desi up for a second attempt at the Whitbread Gold Cup.
They're at the first, and Desert Orchid, they're all safely over the first. Desert Orchid leads from Memberson, and then comes Androma with the Quillifer on the inside of Run and Skip, normally a front runner. But Desert Orchid, Ears Prick comes to take the ditch, jumps it superbly. They're all over the second, and it's Desert Orchid in the lead. Hasn't got as near as warm today as he has in the past. This grey out in front, where he likes to be, leads by length. The run and skip of Memberson and Torside Aquilifa, then Lanarine, Androma and Proud Pilgrim and Golden Minstrel. Then comes Kildaimo, and on the inside, Strands of Golden GA is the back marker. But the grey, Desert Orchid blazing a trail. Desert Orchid in the lead. From run and skip in second, and then comes Memberson racing third. Androma a little bit wide. Strands of Gold towards the rear, and now they level up down towards the third. And it's Desert Orchid leading, and at quite a good pace, a sound pace, by four lengths to run and skip in second. And then comes Torside in third, and Memberson four, and Lanarine five. Aquilifa and Golden Minstrel, Androma and Kildaimo. And then Strands of Golden Proud Pilgrim, and a beautiful jump again by the leader. A little bit of a mistake at the rear of the field with a horse with a noseband, Proud Pilgrim. But they turn into the backstretch, and it's Desert Orchid that leads by two lengths now to run and skip in second. Then in third is, on the inside, Torside. They come to the fourth fence, and Desert Orchid leading over safely. From in second place, run and skip. Behind these comes Memberson, and then Lanarine made ground to go into four. Another superb jump by the leader. And so it's Desert Orchid in the lead, comes to take the ditch superbly. From run and skip in second, and he's spread-eagling his field. GA is finding the pace hot. That's last.
Well, Desert Orchid's corns don't seem to be worrying him today. So far, he's jumped as well as I've ever seen him.
Jumping completely out of his stride. And the one who's taken a while to warm himself up a little bit is Strands of Gold. He's been a bit sketchy over the first few, but he's jumping a little bit better now.
And interestingly, Lanarine has made no effort to go up and take Desert Orchid on. Maybe he can't, mind you, but he took a strong hold going down. I would think that almost certainly Guy Landor's intending to give him a bit more of a chance this year.
So they take the 10th, and it's Desert Orchid that leads. GA just making up a bit of ground. Perhaps Simon Sherwood has steadied the pace a bit. He certainly led them a merry dance over the first three. And they turn now to face up towards the 11th. And it's Desert Orchid that leads. From run and skip in second place, with Memberson close up for him in third. And then comes Golden Minstrel in four, Torside five, Lanarine close up six. They're just bunching up as they come down towards the 11th. And it's Desert Orchid in the lead from Memberson, Golden Minstrel, Androma making ground on the outside, run and skip on the inner, and Lanarine behind that one, and Desert Orchid leads as they come down towards the 11th. And Desert Orchid jumping boldly in the lead. Proud Pilgrim, a little bit of a niggly mistake there. So they've completed a circuit in this 32nd running of the Whipwreck Gold Cup. And it's the grey, Desert Orchid out in front, run and skip on the left of the picture in the yellow jacket, Memberson in the beige behind them as they take the 11th. Crowd really relishing this as they come down towards the 12th. This is an open ditch, and it's Desert Orchid in the lead by a length to Memberson. Run and skip on the inside. Let's see how he jumps this. Oh, quite superbly, the horse in front, Desert Orchid. And the knowledgeable crowd here really relishing this sight, and the order as they pass us, having jumped 13. Is a Desert Orchid leads by length. The run and skip, Torside makes ground on the inner, Lanarine close up, Memberson line across the track, Golden Minstrel only two lengths off the lead, then Androma and Kildaimo, and then Strands of Gold, Aquilifa on the inside, and Proud Pilgrim, and GA is the back marker. So they head towards the 14th fence, and it's Desert Orchid in the lead. They swing right-handed, and Desert Orchid running a bit wide there and giving a bit of ground away, but still on the wide outside. Now shares the lead with Run and Skip. Desert Orchid from Run and Skip, who's come through on the inside. Behind these, Lanarine racing third. In fourth is Torside. Fifth is Memberson. And then making ground on the outside all the time is Golden Minstrel as they take the next fence in there. Desert Orchid led. Another mistake at the rear of the field by Proud Pilgrim. Aquilifa, the 11-2 favourite, not in the picture at the moment. Desert Orchid at 6-1. He's been in the picture throughout. It's been impossible to keep him out of it. And it's Run and Skip on the inside of Desert Orchid as they go down towards the 15th. It's Run and Skip and Desert Orchid racing wide. Desert Orchid in the lead from Run and Skip. Golden Minstrel, a slight mistake. Aquilifa has got a lot to do. That's second from last at the moment as they take the 16th. And Desert Orchid, a superb jump there. He's jumping them into the ground.
Well, he's going to get a little bit further in front than that, John.
Yes, I think Simon's had things played his own way a little bit. Nobody's really been too keen to take him on, and the old horse has been lobbing along with his ears pricked. And as you said, he stood off a whole stride too soon, the first one in the straight there, and got easily as far the other side. But if his main problem was whether he was going to get the trip, and things have been going his way, he ought to get it.
It's very different this year. This is where he packed up last year.
It's six to jump, and Lanarai looks the one who's going to be packing up. That one's last, and Aquilifer is well in arrears. But as they go to the 20th, it's Desert Orchid in the lead from Run and Skip on the inside. At the rear of the field, Lanarai making heavy weather of it. Desert Orchid in the lead by half a length to Run and Skip. Strands of Gold with the white steers are getting closer. Kill Dymo has settled mid-division, but that one now makes ground to go into four. Memberson five, Androma is six. At the rear of the field, Giada is out of it. So too is Lanarai, but they begin the turn into the home straight. They've got three to jump. And Run and Skip now the leader, the horse with the white face. The grey is Desert Orchid. Kill Dymo getting closer. Memberson behind these, and then behind these comes Androma. Strands of Gold is not out of it. The race opens up as they come down towards the 22nd, and it's the grey Desert Orchid now, who may have been given a breather by Simon Sherwood, comes to take the third from home, and it's Desert Orchid who leads there from in second place. Run and Skip, Strands of Gold looks a big danger, that one's going through into third. Kill Dymo, the top weight with the yellow sleeves, on the right of the four as they come down towards the second last, and the crowd walk to this now, and it's Desert Orchid in the lead from Kill Dymo on the right. Strands of Gold in between them, and Kill Dymo is travelling strongly. They come down towards the 24th and final fence. The grey on the left, Desert Orchid. On the right is Kill Dymo. And at the last, Desert Orchid and Kill Dymo jumping together. We've got a race on here. Desert Orchid in the lead from Kill Dymo. And Desert Orchid goes on. Desert Orchid goes on by a length. The roof is being raised here at Sandown as Desert Orchid wins the Whitbread. Desert Orchid, Kill Dymo, Strands of Gold, the 1-2-3. Then Proud Pilgrim and Run and Skip and Androma. And Memberson at Torside behind these Golden Minstrel. And the favourite was Aquilifer, beat only one. That was GA. I have never, ever heard the crowd warm to a horse like they warmed the Desert Orchid. This was a spectacular performance, a superb jumping exhibition by the most popular horse in training. That's number two, Desert Orchid.
Well, after that marvellous victory, Desert Orchid quite rightly became a household name, and at the beginning of the 1988-89 season, he attempted a second successive victory in the Terry Biddlecombe Chase.
So he's coming down to the second last. Desert Orchid is still... Oh, and he hits it quite hard, Desert Orchid. But he's still full of running, and Simon Sherwood looks over his shoulder there to see Bishop's Yarn a long way back in second. Let's see how he jumps the last. He jumps it beautifully, Desert Orchid, and he's a long way clear as he races into that last 150 yards and up towards the line. Gets a great reception from the crowd. He's going to win the Terry Biddlecombe Trophy for the second year running. Tremendously easily, Desert Orchid.
The hugely talented but equally temperamental Vodkatini was receiving lumps of weight from the Flying Grey, so Desert Orchid went off as second favourite for the Tingle Creek Chase. Vodkatini's supporters were left ruining their luck, however, when he refused to start, but it was business as usual for Desert Orchid, who would surely need all of his speed to score over this trip.
They just got three more fences to jump, and Desert Orchid, a winner of 22 races, leading, but Panto Prince, a winner of 12 races on the outside, is second. Jim Thorpe getting a little bit closer, but Desert Orchid yet to be asked for his effort. I should imagine he's probably thinking to himself, well, I've got to go around again, Simon. What's going on here? Panto Prince coming up on the outside of him, coming down towards the third from home. And it's Desert Orchid on the inside, and doesn't he jump well? Jim Thorpe was the one that makes a mistake. And Desert Orchid goes on by a couple of lengths, and Panto Prince comes under pressure, and Jim Thorpe tries to close. Both the two speed horses behind Desert Orchid, who comes down towards the second last and jumped it brilliantly. Jim Thorpe through the top of it, Panto Prince in second place. They race down towards the 13th and final fence, and Desert Orchid looks and thinks this isn't simply an exercise canter. He's five clear as he comes to it, and what a superb jump by Desert Orchid. He's 8 to 10 lengths clear, making specialist two-mile chasers look very one-paced. But amazing performances. Desert Orchid, 12 stone, 12 lengths clear, up towards the line. Desert Orchid, 23rd race, and it'll never be easier.
Desi was odds on to win his second King George the Sixth Chase, but this time Vodkatini condescended to start, and you couldn't rule out his old adversary Kill Dymo.
There's a they come down to the first. Volcatini off with them, 19 finishes the jump, and it's Desert Orchid on the inside. And Volcatini and Cavi's Clan makes a mistake at the first. Go down towards the second, and it's Desert Orchid moving through on the inside of Volcatini. Back to Charter Party and Kildima and Cavi's Clan, and they're at the second. And they're all safely over the second, and again, Cavi's Clan, a bit slow. So they swing right-handed into the back straight and down towards the third. And it's Desert Orchid leading by three lengths to Volcatini and Charter Party. And then Kildemo, and the back marker is Cavi's Clan. In Indian file as they swing right-handed and come down to the third. With Desert Orchid leading out in front. From Volcatini in second, and then Charter Party in third, and Kildemo on the outside, and Cavi's Clan come down towards the third. Desert Orchid in the lead. This is a plain fence. Desert Orchid comes to it. Jumps it well from Volcatini and Charter Party and Kildemo and Cavi's Clan. Now the next one they take is an open ditch, and Desert Orchid with his ears pricked, four clear. Volcatini in second place. This is the fourth. It's a ditch. And Desert Orchid over from Volcatini and Charter Party and Kildemo and Cavi's Clan. And down towards the fifth. And it's Desert Orchid in the lead by three lengths to Volcatini, by four lengths to Charter Party, and Desert Orchid over. Then Volcatini and Charter Party and Kildemo and Cavi's Clown. So they've quite a short run to the sixth, and it's Desert Orchid by four lengths comes to it. Beautiful jump, Volcatini second, and then Charter Party and Kildemo, and a gap of six lengths opening up to Cavi's Clown. So they turn into the home straight and down towards the seventh. Quite a run before they get there. Desert Orchid leading out in front. The winner, 23 races. Desert Orchid leading. Volcatini throwing his head about. And John Oakes, John Frankham, will this help or hinder?
He's pulling very hard in second place. It certainly can't help.
No, it's unfortunate for Peter Hobbs. He's done a good job to get the horse settled well, but in an effort to get him on, he was more or less had to be up the front. And of course, he's a 2-mile horse running a 3-mile chase. And ideally, Peter Hobbs would have liked to have got him settled in at the back of this field. But anyway, at least he's got him off, that's one thing. But he's pulling much too hard for his own good. And it's a pity he just won't settle and give himself a little bit of a chance.
Desert Orchid, by contrast, seems to be settled beautifully in front. He looks really happy, touch wood.
His stable companion, Cavi's Clown, at the rear of the field. In the order as they pass us with the circuit to go, now to the water jump. Out of the 10th, is a Desert Orchid leads from Volcatini in second, and Kildemo going well in third, and Charter Party not out of it in fourth, and a big break opening up to Cavi's Clan. A circuit to go, and they race away to the water jump, and it's Desert Orchid leading, Volcatini on the outside of it, Kildemo on the inner, and Charter Party closing up, and Volcatini has taken on Desert Orchid there, and they go down towards the 11th. This is a plain fence, and it's Volcatini and Desert Orchid, and Desert Orchid and Volcatini outjumped him there. Desert Orchid in second, and Kildemo in third, and Charter Party is fourth. And they, so they go to the next one, which is a ditch, and it's Desert Orchid on the inside of Volcatini, and Desert Orchid and Volcatini from Kildemo, and then comes Charter Party, and Cavi's Clown is just starting to lose touch, and Desert Orchid coming up on the inside. They've got seven more to jump. Desert Orchid in the lead from Volcatini in second, and Kildemo with that very high tail carriage is in third place. Back in four and getting closer, Charter Party, a Gold Cup winner. And they've got seven to jump in this Cork King George's sixth rank chase. And it's Desert Orchid, the 86th winner, the leader from Volcatini in second, then Kildemo and Charter Party in a big, big break to Cavi's Clown. And they go down towards the seventh from home. And it's Desert Orchid on the inside, jumping well from Volcatini, going well in second, and Charter Party and Kildemo, and Cavi's Clown is eight lengths behind. They go down towards the last ditch. This is the 14th, the sixth from home. And it's Desert Orchid and Volcatini, and Desert Orchid and Volcatini, and Charter Party, and then comes Kildemo, and Cavi's Clown is out of it, I would say. They've got five to jump, and as they come down to it, it's Desert Orchid on the inside of Volcatini. Desert Orchid by a length and a half. Oh, a brilliant jump by Desert Orchid from Volcatini. And then came Charter Party and Kildemo. And Cavi's Clown is getting a bit closer. They go to the last on the far side. And Desert Orchid has it. Desert Orchid, another spectacular leap. And Charter Party just a bit slow there, back in four. They've got three to jump. And it's Desert Orchid in the lead from Volcatini in second. And Kildemo is in third. And Charter Party trying to get back on terms again. And Cavi's Clown is there within five lengths now. And they've got three to jump. and it's Desert Orchid in the lead as they turn for home. Three more fences to jump in this King George sixth rank chase, and it's Desert Orchid from Vocatini, and Kildemo is now pulled to challenge, and Charter Party is closing in four again, and we have a real race on here as they come down towards the third last, and Desert Orchid being taken by Vocatini and Kildemo on the outside, but at Desert Orchid the grey finds more as they come down towards the second last. It's Desert Orchid in the lead, and a spectacular jump by Desert Orchid, but Vocatini and Kildemo will not be denied. The other two are out of it, and it's Desert Orchid who finds more as they come down towards the final fence, but Kildemo is pressing hard on the stand side. They come down towards the final fence, and Desert Orchid handles it from Kildemo in second, Vocatini back in third. Chase, Kildemo second, Vocatini third, Cavi's Clown stayed on very well indeed to be four, Charter Party was five, and so the crowd, having seen a spectacular display of jumping by their favourite Desert Orchid, speed from the stands and rush to the winner's enclosure.
That really was a moment to savour. Simon Sherwood and Desert Orchid getting on tremendously well together there. The Victor Chandler chase gave Vocatini a chance for revenge, and Panto Prince looked pretty well weighted.
And it's Panto Prince with a 2.5 length advantage at the moment over Desert Orchid. Long engagement, a very close third, then a gap to Ida's Delight. As they race towards the next, Panto Prince from Desert Orchid, and Desert getting right back close to Panto Prince now, probably being given a breather by Simon Sherwood. Panto Prince, though, landed in the lead. Panto Prince from Desert Orchid and long engagement right up close too. Coming down to the next, Panto Prince lands in the lead from Desert Orchid and long engagement. Panto Prince by a length and a half from Desert Orchid and long engagement. Ida's Delight's a long way back. Panto Prince from Desert Orchid and long engagement. Racing towards the third last now in the Victor Chandler. Panto Prince on the inside. Desert Orchid and long engagement, very close indeed. Racing to the home turn now. Panto Prince on the inside of Desert Orchid and long engagement. Very little between the three now as they turn for home with two fences left to jump. Panto Prince on the inside. Desert Orchid in between him and long engagement towards the right of the picture. Panto Prince coming to the second last with the advantage from Desert Orchid. 22 pound between them. Panto lands in the lead from Desi, who's challenging again. Coming down to the final fence now. Panto Prince on the far side. Desert Orchid on the near side. Challenging again as they come towards the last. Panto Prince from Desert Orchid. There's very little between them now. As they come to the final fence in the Victor Chandler. Panto Prince on the far side. Desert Orchid lands in the lead. Desert Orchid on the near side. Panto Prince on the far side. Here's where the 22 pounds is going to tell. Panto Prince on the far side. Desert Orchid fighting back though. Desi's fighting back like a tiger as he comes to the line. It's a photo. Desi's won it. He's won it. Desert Orchid has won it.
That was perhaps the greatest finish Ascot had ever witnessed. And seeing Desert Orchid's courage there, it's hard to believe that he once ran in blinkers. In the Gainsborough chase, Desi was once again giving weight away all round.
They've got five to jump. And it's Pegwell Bay and Desert Orchid and Kildemo getting much, much closer on the inside. Charter Party back in four out, and Desert Orchid now again on the outside of Pegwell Bay. Kildemo is getting much closer in third place, just two lengths adrift, and Charter Party isn't out of it either, going well back in fourth place. And they start to turn in now with all to play for in this race called Gainsborough Chase. They've got three to jump, and Pegwell Bay going into unknown territory now, a winner over 2.5 miles. He's tackling three today. Desert Orchid, a winner of 25 races. Charter Party is closing, and Kildemo is not out of it. It's going to be a sprint for home now with three to jump, and it's Desert Orchid on the outside of Pegwell Bay, and Pegwell Bay has the initiative by length. Desert Orchid in second place under 12 stone, conceding well over a stone to the one in front, Pegwell Bay, and they're in line for home. And Kildemo's in third place, and two out is Pegwell Bay, but Desert Orchid jumps up superbly and gets a tremendous roar from the crowd. And Pegwell Bay now comes under pressure, and they race down towards the final fence. And it's Desert Orchid and Pegwell Bay, and Desert Orchid takes it. Desert Orchid from Pegwell Bay on the far side. Kildemo back in third, but Pegwell Bay is sticking to his guns. Will the Orchid bloom? It's Desert Orchid finishing fast, and Desert Orchid blooms. Desert Orchid wins. because it feels going to be hell. My heart was in my mouth. I don't know where yours was. But boy, oh boy, Simon Sherwood has gained the day on number one, Desert Orchid.
The scene was now set for his first attempt at the most prestigious steeplechase in the world, the Cheltenham Gold Cup.
Go straight the rest of you. Lead him in at the back. Come on!
Oh, yeah. Run away.
Go on!
And to a great roar from the crowd, they race to the first of the 22 fences. Bonanza Boy over on the far side, Desert Orchid in the centre of the fence, Charter Party and Slalom between horses. Gavi's Clown jumps it last, and Desert Orchid has gone to the front as they race to the second. Desert Orchid from 10 plus towards the near side. Charter Party and Slalom and Yahoo and Bonanza Boy, and behind them come Pegwell Bay, and behind Pegwell is West Tip, and then the Thinker, then Golden Freeze, Ballyhane, Carville's Hill and Cabby's Clown. Desert Orchid swings round this first turn in the lead from 10 plus and Charter Party, with just behind them Slalom, Bonanza Boy and Yahoo. Then Pegwell Boy on the far side is West Tip, then the Thinker, Ballyhane, Golden Freeze, Carville's Hill over the third, and Cabby's Clown. They race now down towards the water. Desert Orchid from Charter Party and 10 plus, Yahoo on the far side, Pegwell Bay on the near side. Slalom was between horses, all safely over the water and racing now to the first of the ditches, with Desert Orchid on the inside of Charter Party as they jump it, 10 plus right up with them. Another plain one before the second ditch. Desert Orchid at the sixth from Charter Party and 10 plus, Pegwell Bay and Yahoo. And it looks as though Golden Freeze has gone at that one. Golden Freeze has gone at that. 12 left. The next ditch, Desert Orchid lands from Charter Party and Pegwell Bay. And Carville's Hill's gone there. The Hope of Ireland has gone at the second ditch. This is the eighth. Desert Orchid lands in the lead from Charter Party and Pegwell Bay. 10 plus on the outside. As they run downhill, Yahoo comes next, then Slalom, then Bonanza Boy. The two loose horses seem to be all right, Carville's Hill and Golden Freeze. Over the ninth, Desert Orchid lands in the lead from Charter Party and Pegwell Bay, 10 plus. Then on the outside, Yahoo. West Tip's not far behind the lead, nor's the Thinker. Bonanza Boy on the inside. This is the 10th. Desert Orchid lands in the lead, 10 plus, Charter Party, Pegwell Bay, Yahoo. And the Thinker's gone at that one. The Thinker has gone. Horse and jockey up all right, so 10 left now in the 1989 Gold Cup as they run down towards the fence. It'll be the second last on the next circuit, number 11, this time of the 22 fences, and it's Desert Orchid from 10 plus and Charter Party and Pegwell Bay and Yahoo and Slalom and Bonanza Boy, and behind them Ballyhane, West Tip and Cabby's Clown, getting closer to the front all the time. Desert Orchid on the far side, in the center of the fence, 10 plus. On the near side, Cabby's Clown, then Yahoo, then Charter Party and Pegwell Bay. Mistake there by Bonanza Boy. Desert Orchid on the inside of Cabby's Clown and 10 plus. These three almost matching strides. 10 plus taking a fractional advantage now from Desert Orchid. Cabby's Clown on the inside. Charter Party, 4-5, Yahoo, 6 Slalom, 7 and 8 of Pegwell Bay and West Tip. 9 is Bonanza Boy and 10 Ballyhane as they run downhill now with 10 left to jump. 10 plus just in the lead now from Desert Orchid on the inside over this one. Desert Orchid again on the inside of 10 plus as they run down to the water. Bonanza Boy going well up on the outside. Slalom is still well in contention. So is Yahoo. Desert Orchid on the inside, on the far side, 10 plus, then Charter Party, then Cavi's Clown, Slalom, Bonanza Boy, and Yahoo and Pegwell Bay. Mistake there by West Tip as they race towards the 16th now. 10 plus, Cavi's Clown, Desert Orchid, Yahoo. Now racing to the final ditch. Six from home and 10 plus has taken a three-length advantage from Desert Orchid. Charter Party, the former winner, is third. Yahoo is four. Cavi's Clown, five. Pegwell Bay, six. Beautiful jump by Desert Orchid. Takes him within a length of 10 plus. In third, Charter Party. Slalom was a faller there. Yahoo is fourth. Ballyhane is back in fifth now. Five from home. 10 plus landed in the lead. From Desert Orchid, second. Charter Party, third. Yahoo, four. Ballyhane, five. Cavi's Clown, six. Running downhill now. And it's four to jump now with 10 plus with a four-length advantage over Desert Orchid. Still in there fighting. Yahoo coming there. He loves the mud on the far side. Charter Party in fourth. 10 plus, Desert Orchid, then Yahoo, then Charter Party, then Ballyhane. Racing down now towards the third last in the Gold Cup, and as they do so, it's 10 plus being pressed by Desert Orchid, then Yahoo. Behind them comes Charter Party. This is the third last now. Desert Orchid, and 10 plus is gone. He's left Desert Orchid in the lead. It's Desert Orchid now as they race to the home turn from Yahoo, chasing him all the time and trying to get up on the inside with Charter Party third. Desert Orchid and Yahoo now as they race round the home turn. There's very little between them. Yahoo on the far side. He's gone on now from Desert Orchid towards the near side. Yahoo from Desert Orchid, and Desert Orchid looks as though he's tiring in the ground. Yahoo, who loves the mud, is full of running at the second last. Yahoo jumps from Desert Orchid, but Desert Orchid is running. He's trying to come again towards the near side. It's Yahoo on the far side. Desert Orchid towards the near side. And even the bookmakers will be cheering this favorite. Just everybody wants to get close to him. Well, Desert Orchid's getting a fair massaging from his supporters. And there's Janice Coyle with Desi and Richard Burridge.
Desert Orchid had fulfilled his destiny, but his season wasn't over yet.
And Desert Orchid leads Charter Party. Delius getting closer on the outside of Bow Ranger on the inner. A little gap then to Hungry Her, and then Yahoo, and behind Yahoo weather the storm, and then Bishop's Yarn as they come to the 12th. Desert Orchid from Charter Party. Delius jumps. Desert Orchid is gone. Desert Orchid a faller, and Charter Party's gone too. Desert Orchid is up all right. Desert Orchid's up all right. He brought down Charter Party. Desi's rider is still to rise. Simon Sherwood. They may well have fell independently, those two, you know. There's the grey jumping all right, riderless. Richard Dunwood is up on his feet all right, but Simon Sherwood is yet to rise. Yes, he's up on his feet all right. There's Simon.
It may have ended prematurely, but Desert Orchid, the champion, racing's hero, lives to fight another day. We'll be right back.